Hey everyone, Phil Spencer here. Really excited. We're going to get to talk about Grounded. Great game, a game I love playing. We have Adam Brennecke here from the team. Go ahead and introduce yourself.
I'm the game director, and thanks so much for having me. I'm super excited to be here finally. We're at the end of the runway for Grounded, and it's a super exciting time.
Yeah, I mean, Grounded is a game we've been playing, for like a couple years now. Started in game preview, in Game Pass. I think it's been amazing to see what over 10 million people have played the game to date. I've played a ton. I love it. Can't wait for the 27th of September when we get 1.0, GA, story mode, all of the great things that are coming. To me, when I think about all of the games that we're building, one of the things I really love about Grounded is you find a passionate team, which you lead, a passionate team that has a real creative idea, maybe something that isn't exactly expected from the studio, but you had a vision about something you were going to go build, and that we could work together, foster, grow that, to the point we're at now where it's getting ready to release. I think it's fantastic.
Yeah, it's wild to be like in this position to be able to make something so creative. If this is the first time you're hearing about Grounded or seeing Grounded, Grounded is a survival game and you have to survive in this backyard environment. The main goal is to get home. We're at the end of our journey of building the game and with the community, and this is the final update for the full complete yard.
It's the biggest update yet, right?
Yeah. We have a bunch of cool surprises, a lot of cool new environments that are going to be really fun to explore.
Yeah.
The team's pouring their hearts into it right now. And I think it's just been so fun to work alongside the community too, that we built with the early access and game preview programs. So many players have given us great feedback along the way. And it's really shaped how we developed Grounded. Right now, we're actually checking out one of the early adventure areas in the game. It's the hedge. You're shrunk down to the size of an ant.
Yeah.
And
actually, I think the ants are bigger than you are.
They're a little bit bigger, right? Yeah. The players right now are going through this hedge maze, and it's nestled on the side of the house. You're trying to figure out how you got here and how you're going to get home. Part of the adventure is exploring all these cool areas and environments of the yard. One thing that we're really proud of for our final 1.0 release is our story.
Yeah.
And I think that's one thing that really separates us from most survival games. And we spent a lot of time world building, adding a lot of characters and storylines to the world.
Yeah, I think there's, for me, I played in game preview, Game Pass. It was a great co-op game because we get together as our friends. One of the fantastic ways to go play, build our base. I happened to go visit right around the Xbox Bethesda showcase. It was fun to come out to the studio, you and I getting together. Got me re-energized. So I went back into the game, but so much had changed. And now I'm so waiting for that story mode, the setting, because the story, it's a great setting for a story, kind of have a guided beginning of the game. And then the sandbox will obviously just open up for players. And how will you deal with, I assume you'll have some players who will be like me, returning of the 10 million people who have played when it comes out. And then you have other players who are brand new, where the idea of, okay, now it's at 1.0, now is when I'm gonna go dive in. Like you as a team, how do you think about those kind of different players coming and how do you design for that?
Yeah, so I think the one thing that, we wanna invite all the players that have tried Grounded, even 2 years ago, we want them to come back and try it again and experience the full story, experience the full yard, because there's so much content in this yard. It's a big open world. There's so many cool environments, cool creatures to find. But I also for the brand new player, it's a survival game first and foremost, but it's definitely a different twist on a survival game. There's one thing that we're really proud of is the accessibility and approachability. So even just right now, we're looking at the broodmother fight. So this is one of our boss fights in the game where you fight this giant spider in her spider den. It looks kind of funny because we have an arachnophobia mode.
And that's
one thing that's really important to us is making the game accessible for all different types of players. We have tons of game options. So even if survival seems, that might be a hardcore genre of game, we're trying to bring in a huge audience with a lot of options to play the game how you want to play. I think that's really important to us.
And we saw that in the community, certain people just focused on the base building and building, frankly, almost levels or bases that took over the whole size of the lake, which was awesome. I think you're going to get a lot of people who want story. I think the boss battles and the kind of the circle of collecting items, building up your crew so you can go in mm-hmm. and take down different parts of the game. Awesome.
People built huge fortresses and spent an enormous amount of time building these crazy, crazy, huge forts. And then that gave us ideas of adding more.
Yeah.
So we added mushroom bricks and we want to add more building materials in the future.
Well, and that loop that you're commenting on now, I don't think that it's not always recognized how important that is. It's like a team has a vision. That vision meets reality of through Game Pass and preview, 10 million people play and continue to play. And then they're going to give you feedback. And that will actually change your production schedule, mm-hmm. right? Because you're going to listen and watch what people do.
Yeah, even as simple as like sitting in chairs. I know that was a fun one that we put in like a year ago.
Yeah.
That was a huge ask. Just like people just want to lounge around in their base, right? They built this huge just...
Now
it's
something,
yeah, it's to chill, right? One thing for our 1.0 release, there's a couple more surprise boss fights that we're really excited about.
Any hints or no?
Well, we did show off the Mantis.
Yeah.
So that's something that I know a lot of players have been asking for a long time, to fight a praying Mantis in Grounded. So we are delivering that experience. And we got a couple more surprises.
That's awesome. Well, congrats to the team on getting to this point. We're not quite there yet, 27 September.
Thank you.
I think for everybody who's played, myself included, I just love the craftsmanship and passion that clearly the team has in putting together such an amazing game. That's a great game to play either by yourself or with your friends. Can't wait to see it come out. And it's great to be here and get to show people more of the game. So thanks for all of that.
Yeah, thank you.